Our next guest's stellar song, Until I Found You, has been played nearly 28 million times. It's gone viral online and it definitely plucks the heartstrings.
Stephen Sanchez is the heartthrob behind the hit and Tristan and I spoke to him recently. Have a look.
Yeah, I mean, it says it right out of the gate, you know, with the first verse, which is the song is about this girl named Georgia. And we were together for quite some time and I wrote it last summer when we were together. And it was just mirroring this time when we weren't dating and we were trying to. And I pushed her away. And it was talking about how I was just lost before I got to have her again. And then I, I found my way.
Look at this romantic right here. Yeah, the song has blown up online. Over 500,000 people have creations with your song on TikTok. Apart from the fact that it's an amazing song, why do you think it's gone viral?
Oh, gosh, I don't know. Love is just the most human thing ever, you know, and because it's just something that you can feel, something that you can see, something that you can choose. And I think that, you know, that is something that is universally, you know, experienced. And I feel like, you know, I don't know why it's this song and why it's me who wrote it, but I'm grateful. And I think people can just relate to love, you know, the most out of anything, you know, apart from pain, you know, so.
Yeah, love, look, love is messy and the best songs are written in those messy parts of life, right? You fell in love with music through a bit of an old-fashioned way. Tell us how it all started.
Yeah, I mean, I grew up, you know, in the church and, you know, there was music that, you know, already was so powerful gospel music to me. And so I grew up a lot around that, but even just apart from that, you know, I had two sets of grandparents on one side, one of my grandpas played guitar and sang and, you know, could play just about anything really. And then on the other side of that, my other grandpa had this large amount of land and these two barns. And in either of the barns, he would send me out and he would have me pick through thousands of boxes of vinyl that he had, because he used to collect vinyl and, you know, take vinyl from the trash cans of these old, you know, abandoned radio stations, you know, back in the 60s. And so he had a lot of vinyl and a lot of first pressings. And so he sent me home with anything from the Platters to the Ink Spots to Nat King Cole, Frank Sinatra, you know, Jimmy Durant, all these crooners and artists who sang about love in this really, really simple way that was also, you know, profound. And I even relate to it, you know, today. And I think a lot of people do. And so that's kind of where all that came from.
Oh, that's great. You can almost hear that. You can almost hear that fusion within that song because it's quite a modern song, but it has that kind of old-fashioned sound to it. I absolutely love it. You seem to have the knack for amazing songs, but also the kind of the viral and the content side of stuff, because you shared a snippet of your other song, Lady by the Sea, a multi-platinum singer then Jeremy Zucker. He reached out to produce it. Over 4 million streams now. You've nailed it.
Yeah.
Did you ever expect this?
Man, thank you so much. Not at all. I mean, I think like... I don't think anybody does really. I mean, you look at everybody and you try and fit the shoes of your heroes with what you know how to do. And I think just for me, it was just a lot of just trying to figure out how to do what, you know, everybody that I looked up to was doing. And I think that that's a really beautiful thing too, for everybody who does music and who plays and writes, is that it looks different for every single person. And somehow, you know, I have no idea how I got this far, but it's really
pretty amazing. Pretty amazing for someone who in high school was known as the kid who played guitars and wrote songs, right?
Yeah, man, you know, y'all know your stuff. It's awesome. Wow, yeah. I mean, the high school was crazy time for that. That was like all I was known for, too.
Are we going to see that guy in Australia soon?
Yeah.
I'd love to. I mean, I've never been to Australia, and you know, I've really never been on a plane that long either, which is pretty crazy. Yeah.
It's worth it.
Yeah.
Also, I've got to ask you very quickly before we let you go, how is Georgia these days?
Oh boy. I appreciate you asking that. I recently sent her the new EP, Easy on My Eyes, which, you know, comes out August 19th. And but I sent it to her first, you know, before anybody, and I just let her know, like, and we haven't spoken in some time too, and I was just like, hey, you know, I just want to acknowledge the fact that this is coming out and there are songs on here that are about you, and I'd rather them come from me than from somebody else or for you to see it online over and over and over again. And so I just told her that, you know, I hope she's doing well. And she texted me back and, you know, she told me she's doing good and that she appreciated that. And yeah.
Oh, so, that's awesome. Maybe that's not the end of that story. Who knows? Stephen's new EP, Easy on My Eyes, is out on the 19th of August. Hey, thank you so much for chatting with us today. We've loved it.
Thank you so much. It's been such an honor and a privilege to be on this. It's
You're awesome.
Awesome.
We can't wait till everyone else finds you and your music. You're awesome. Take care, mate.
Yeah. Cheers, y'all. Great to meet you.